Hi guys, this is Mike. In this Cinema 4D tutorial, I'm going to talk about some tips and techniques that will be useful for 3D modeling. Okay, in this first example, I'm going to talk about edge flow. Now, you can see that we have two very similar modeling compositions here. And if you zoom in a little bit on the first one, you can see that we have sort of a bit of a deformation along the edge of this curve, this sort of ridge that we have modeled into this object. Now, right now I have a subdivision on each one of these objects, and you can see that one is a lot smoother than the other. And if I bring up garage shading, so you can press NB on your keyboard, you can see how dense this model is in the first one. Now, if I zoom in a little bit, you can see how this mesh goes across this ridge. And it kind of goes along in a sort of a diagonal area, goes against the grain to this curve on this edge. Now, if you take a look at this second model, you can see how this curve, how this model is laid out in terms of its topology. And you can see it kind of wraps over and around the curve going along with it. So the thing to take away from this example is you want to make your edge flow go correspond to the edge of your curve. And if I take off the subdivision surface to this model, you can see how it's laid out in terms of the model. And so when you subdivide it, doesn't matter how many times you subdivide, you're going to get this really nice curve and it's really nice smooth. Now, if I go back to my original example, the first example, you can see how dense this mesh is, especially when you kind of pull back, you can see it's almost a different color in terms of how dark it is. So you can use a lot lower of a mesh, and you can keep the polygon count down a lot more when you use this technique of going along the curve of your object. So it's a very important thing to take away from this example, is that whenever you're modeling, you make sure you model so that it's advantageous to subdivision. So you can see as this has been subdivided, no matter how much we increase the subdivisions, make sure I'm on the right subdivision, you're still going to have this deformation in the corners. So it's an important point to take away from this. So let me bring this back. Okay, moving on to this example here, we have two of these objects. They're very identical, except when I click on them and I turn on my subdivision surface, you can see that it doesn't curve the way that I expected it to. So it doesn't round off these hard edges. And so if I turn on the subdivision surface of my second example, you can see this is what I was expecting. I see a nice smooth tube. So why isn't this object smoothing over like this one here? So one of the reasons is that you have an object that doesn't have connection points and they're not connected. So if I go to point mode and I go to my live selection and I select my object, and I select this point, you can see when I move it, it's not connected to this object. Now, if you're using an object, if you're using a model and you have this experience with an object, how would you know that these objects aren't connected, these points aren't connected? So one thing you can do is you can go to model, modeling, and then mesh checking. And if you enable mesh checking, let me turn off the subdivision surface. You can see this green highlight that goes around the edges. So if we come down here and we see boundary edges, and you can see that's marked in green, that means that there is an edge and it's not connected. So another way you can check this is if you go to polygon mode and say you select a polygon and then you go to select and then you say go down to select connected right here, you can see that it selects all the polygons that are connected. And you can tell that these edges and these points aren't connected because it's not selecting the rest of your model. So in order to fix this, what you would need to do is you would have to put it into a connect object. You can see right away how the phone changes, the shading changes on your object. So when you enable the connect object, you can see now when I turn on the subdivision surface, how this connects. And you have this subdivision. Now, if you go to your connect, you can see that you have a tolerance where you can weld. You can increase this if you're experiencing some objects that aren't connecting right away. Now, what you can also do is you can go to back to your tube, back to your object, and let me turn off my subdivision surface. If I go to point mode, what you can also do is you can go to select all your points, and you can right click, go to optimize, and we're going to go to this little gear here. This is also going to give you a similar value system that you had with your connect. So if you click OK, you can see it also connects those points. So you have a few different options when you have that issue where it's not connecting. Okay, let's move to this next example. Now we have a situation where we have an object that is smooth using subdivision surface, but it's not connecting right here. And what we have is a sort of an object that has this weird kind of pinch, and it's something that you may not expect. So if you click on your object, and we'll turn off our subdivision surface, what you can see is, and we still have our mesh checking on, we have this red line that goes around that point, the same point where we had our pinching. So let's go back to our model and modeling, and we'll go to our mesh checking. And with our mesh checking enabled, let's go to where we have a red color and we have non-manifold. So what non-manifold is when you have a polygon that has a connection to another polygon in more than one side. So we can take a look at this. If we go to our live selection, polygon mode, select these polygons, go to select, hide selection, and now let's zoom in a little bit. Now you can see here what we have is this little cap on this tube, this part of the tube. So what's happening is when you see when you experience this deformation, this issue, you can always use your mesh checking to make sure if you have a non-manifold or a polygon with multiple sides, connection sides. So simply what we would do is we would select these polygons and we would delete. And let's optimize so we can get rid of those extra points that we deleted our faces. And then we'll go to our select, make sure we're in polygon mode, and we'll go to unhide all. And let's zoom out a little bit. And now if I turn my subdivision surface on, now you can see that we have this nice smoothing that we would expect from our subdivision surface. Okay, so let's move on to our next example. If you take a look at this object, you can see something isn't quite right, and you would see it a little bit better if you did a render. And let's make sure my object is selected, and you can see if we do a render, something isn't quite right. We don't have something working the way that we would want it. And this is really sort of a shading issue, and sometimes you'll be working with a model and you'll notice something that's not connecting correctly with your shading. And something just doesn't, it seems off with your shading. So this usually means that you have normals that have been reversed. And one of the best ways you can check your normals is if you go to your polygon mode and you select all, you can see that we have a blue loop that goes along our model, and then we have orange in the rest. The orange is the normals facing in the correct direction. And you have your normals that are blue, those are faced in the backwards position. So one way you can check your normals is if you go to Shift V and you go to Polygon Normals, and you can see that we have this line that's sticking out from our normals facing the correct direction. But if we go to our other normals, you can see that we don't have this white line sticking out. So it's a way of checking to see which direction your normals is facing. You can see that white line, and these are going in the opposite direction. So in order to fix this, you have two options. You can simply select all and then go to right click and then align normals, and that will align the normals to its correct position. So let me undo. And what you could also do is you could go to your UL or whatever selection tool and select the polygons that are reversed normals. You can go to right click and you can go to reverse normals, and that will also fix that. And now you can see that these white lines are facing the right direction. Okay, so let's go to our next tip. And this is about resolving the spherical poles that you have when you have a sphere. So I'm going to go to my object and I'm going to turn off my subdivision surface. You can see that when we have a sphere, we have this pole right at the top. It's not very advantageous to subdivision because number one, it's a complex pole, and we have these triangles right at the top. We generally want to avoid triangles, and if you're in a workflow where you're not allowed to have triangles, you're gonna have to figure out a way to resolve this pole, resolve this top of your sphere. So how do you go about getting rid of these triangles? Well, first let's take a look at the subdivision and see what's going on here. So you can see when I subdivide, you have these quads that are looking what you would expect. You would see a nice quad, but when you come up here, now you start seeing this looping arc pattern that starts to happen when you have these triangles. And it loops around and it makes this very weird looking pattern. And you can see it more when you go to your render. You can see this sort of a starburst kind of pattern that we have at the top. And if I pull back a little bit, you can see it a little bit better. And this is going to be an issue. It just doesn't look correct. We have this weird look to it. So let's move over a little bit to a duplicate copy of that sphere. It's the same thing. And what we want to do is we want to resolve these triangles. So what I'm going to do is select my sphere. And I want to come over to, I'm actually going to turn off. You can see that mesh checking is indicating that there is a complex pole. So I'm going to go to my mode, modeling, and you can see that purple, you can see complex pole is enabled. I'm just going to turn off mesh checking just so I don't have to distracted by any of these extra colors. So I want to go to edge mode and let's go to our top view. Zoom out a little bit. So one way we can get rid of these triangles is if we select every other edge. Now in modeling, whenever you model something, you want to make sure that you always model with exactly even segments. That's pretty much across the board, and this will help you resolve issues when you're using when you're modeling. You always want to go even. You never want to use like 7. You want to make sure you're using 8, 12, and so on. So we're going to select every other polygon, every other edge, excuse me, and we're going to go to right click and dissolve. Okay, so what we have now is a quad at the top here. And if I go to my edge mode, you can see we have 1, 2, 3, 4. So now we have a quad. But now we still have this pole. And that doesn't really help us when I go to my subdivision. We still have this weird looking effect here. And when I render, you can still see this starburst. Okay, so another way, we're gonna have to get rid of that pole. So we're gonna have to come up with a solution that's going to get rid of this pole. So one way you can go is if you select your object, and if I go to my top view again, so one thing we could do is we could select all our edges and simply just right click and dissolve. So now we have this N-gon. So how do we resolve this N-gon? So what I'm going to do is you can use your knife tool, and I'm going to keep it at single line, and I like to go into point mode. So I'm going to start right and cut it right through the center and then crisscross. And then what I want to do is start making quads by connecting these points. So now we have quads, And what you do is you go back and forth until you resolve all of your, resolve this n-gon. So, whoops. And let me just undo, I have an extra point there. And so what you would do is connect these up. So now we have five, so what we're gonna have to do is put a edge right here and an edge right here. And what we have is quads all the way around our object, all the way around the top here. So now we've resolved that we don't have triangles and we don't have a complex pole. So let's go to our perspective mode and let's zoom out a little bit and let's do a render. So the issue now is that we have this flat top, and that totally makes it, it doesn't resolve our issue having this strange deformation. We got rid of the starburst, but now this flat top is an issue. Okay, so the reason why is because this pole was giving us that curve. So as we dissolved it, now it's just flattening out that top there. So let's move on to this other sphere and see if we can resolve this. Well, one thing what we could do is if I go to my top view, one thing we can do is if I go back to my knife tool, I can bring in the same pattern that we had before. So I'll make my cuts just as I did with my previous example. Because I want to keep the curvature of this pole. And so let's make sure we have Let's make sure I do this correctly. And you can always use your previous example as a reference. So now we sort of have this mess of a mesh. So what we would have to do, and go to our move tool. And so what we want to do is we want to get rid of all of these lines that are coming into this pole. So what you can do is you can go to edge mode, double click, if we double click on our edge, that'll go along our path here, make sure we get all our edges. Now some are gonna go off onto the others all the way through, but we can fix that in just a minute. So if you go along and select these these edges, in an attempt to make sure we get rid of this pole, let me just deselect that one edge I picked up. Okay, so we have our lines. Let me zoom out and I just want to deselect these ones. We'll have our tolerance selection on, and holding down control, we can simply just click and drag, deselect these edges here. Okay, so now what we can do is we can simply just right click and dissolve. There's one left over. Dissolve. Okay, so let's go to our perspective mode. Now you can see we kept our curvature to a certain extent. So let's go to our render. We render, you can still see a little bit of deformation. Now it's a little bit better than what we had from before, but it's still not perfect. So in order to resolve this, the best way is to use a lower resolution when using your spheres. So we have the same object, except it's at a very low sphere. We have about eight segments. And if I select my object, and I go to my edges, and we'll just simply select these edges, and we'll dissolve. Now you can see that we have this nice quad system at the top. It's not a complex pole, so we have that removed. We don't have triangles, and we have this curve at a very low resolution. So when I turn on my subdivision surface, you can see this curves nicely. And if I go to my render, you can see that we have this very nice smooth curve. There's no deformations. We can, right now I'm in the editor in the viewport. So if I turn that up a little bit, you can see that we smooth this out to a nice perfect curve, nice perfect sphere. So just to recap, what you would need to do is make sure you start at a low resolution when you're going to resolve any type of poles on a spherical object. I put a link in the description to download project files. You can also go to astronomic3d.com to download project files from this tutorial and all the tutorials that I've made so far. Thanks for watching.